My name is Andy Ziegler, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Edge team. And today we're going to talk about version rollback, which is a new feature in Edge. First, I'll talk about what it is and what it's for. I'll give you a couple ways to invoke a rollback, and I'll give you a demo of that as well. So rollback is part of a new solution that we're proposing to version management. So overall, the problem is that many administrators have lots of line of business applications to perform critical business functions like accounting and marketing. And every time a new browser version is released, they have to do a test pass and ensure that that new browser version works with their existing line of business apps. And what we're proposing is, instead of preemptively managing the browser version, which can be expensive and can actually leave users exposed to security issues, we're proposing that administrators try a new approach, which is to use automatic update to keep Edge updated automatically to the latest version. And then if they encounter a compatibility issue, to use rollback to treat that. So rollback lets you easily go back to a known working version of Edge. So we think of this as kind of a temporary fix and a safety net. So imagine that you're on Edge 86 and you want to upgrade to 87. And you do that. If you encounter an issue, rollback lets you go back temporarily. And when you've resolved the issue, you can just upgrade back to 87 and continue on. There are a couple of technical challenges with rollback that we've solved. So the first is to prevent downgrade attacks. So generally speaking, we don't want devices to go backwards. Our newest versions always contain the latest security updates, and so staying on the new version is really important. And so we've restricted this capability just to IT administrators to prevent regular consumers from being exposed to those attacks. The second thing is that it's actually kind of difficult to preserve user data. So as you know, the browser stores lots of data for users, like favorites and cookies and history and passwords. And the issue is that because the browser generally only upgrades, the Chromium architecture only really allows user data to upgrade. So you can get into this situation, like if you roll back from 87 to 86 and that user has 87 user data, the 86 browser doesn't know how to load it. And so we have a few solutions to that problem. The first is that there's a data cleaner that will automatically clear up user data that it doesn't know how to load. The next feature that we have is sync. So we recommend that if you need to do a rollback, that you first enable sync through group policy. And then we understand that there are some devices and some enterprises that can't enable sync for a variety of reasons. And so we have a new capability called snapshots that take a snapshot of user data when you do an upgrade from an older version to a newer version, in case we need to replay that for a rollback. So how does rollback work? The first thing that happens is that the browser application actually gets downgraded from the newer version to the older version. When the older version boots up, the first thing it does is to clear out user data because it can't read it. If there's a snapshot available and we've taken one, we'll restore that automatically. And then if sync's enabled, we will download that data from the cloud and automatically get users back to where they were going. And so sync is really the best solution here because the snapshot won't contain data from the newer browser. So imagine you rolled out 87 and it took a few days before you noticed an issue. That few days of browsing data would be lost if you didn't have sync enabled. But the snapshot will get them back to that working state, like it was a few days before. There are a couple different ways to do rollback. The first is through MSIs. So this is really simple. You just take whichever version you want to install and you add an additional command parameter called allow downgrade, and that will actually let Edge do a downgrade. And then the preferred way is actually through Edge update. So the way this works is that you just deploy Edge, you let it update itself. And if you encounter an issue, there are a couple of group policies that you can set that will allow you to just type in whichever version you want and deploy the group policy. And Edge update will handle the details of getting those devices back to whichever version you want. So now I'll give you a quick demo of a couple of different ways to do rollback. Today I'm going to show you two ways to use version management and rollback. We'll start by looking at the details of how rollback works by getting our hands on with the MSIs, doing an upgrade, and then rolling back to a previous version. Then I'll show you how to use group policy with Edge update to do the same thing. So let's start with MSIs. Here I have version 86, and I've made some customizations. So I've set the dark theme, I have a few favorites, some passwords, and other data. and I'm ready to move to Edge 87. So we'll go ahead and upgrade it with an MSI. So I have a couple here on my desktop. Let's MSI exec install Edge 87. All right, so it looks like that's completed. And you'll notice that we're still actually running Edge 86. We actually have to restart the browser as not to interrupt people when we do updates. So we'll go ahead and restart the browser now and it should pick up Edge 87. All right, let's check our version. And you can see we moved to Edge 87. All right, so one important thing that's happened is that Edge has actually taken a snapshot of the 86 data. And so if we look in our user data folder, you can actually see there's snapshots and then Edge 86. And if we poke in here, we can see that there's actually a folder for each profile that was there, data about the first run state. If we look in here, we can see there's cookies, favorites, history, and other data that's stored in this snapshot. Okay, so let's pretend that we encounter a compatibility issue with Edge 87 and we want to actually downgrade back to 86. So we'll go ahead and do that and we'll kind of simulate that with our MSIs. So let's go back to our command prompt, and to do the downgrade, we'll just install Edge 86 on top of Edge 87 and Edge will take care of the rest. So I'll run this and we get an error and it actually says a newer version of Microsoft Edge Enterprise Installer is already installed. And so what this means is that by default, we don't actually allow our versions to go backwards. And we do that for a number of reasons, including downgrade attacks and other security concerns. So if you want to downgrade, we actually only give that capability to administrators. And one of the ways that we do that is with MSIs as a command line parameter. So we actually need to give this MSI a special parameter to allow downgrade. Okay, so it looks like that's completed. And so let's restart our browser. And you can see that the browser's come back up. Let's see what version it is. And you can see it's 86. And you can also see that my preferences, like my dark mode setting, my favorites, and all the other data that was in that snapshot has been restored. So this really helps to minimize user interruption in the case that you encounter a compatibility or other issue with a new Edge version. And so we do recommend that you, of course, set up sync because this snapshot data doesn't have anything that I did in Edge 87, right? It's just a copy from the last state when you did the upgrade. So we definitely recommend enabling sync, but this is kind of how snapshots work. Okay, so now let's take a look at how to do version management with Edge Update. I have two devices for this. I have a client device, which has the latest version of Edge Dev, and we're going to do this demo with Edge Dev. And I have a server device that is the domain controller, and we'll use that to set up a new group policy object and roll back the current version of Edge. So imagine that the latest version of Edge Dev encountered some type of problem with a website that you have, and you want to roll it back to the last version. So that's what we'll do. So we'll go ahead and pop over to our server, and I've got my group policy management UI open up. And so I'll create a new group policy object, and we'll call it Edge Dev version. And I've already imported the latest group policy templates from the Edge business site. And so I will go ahead and edit this. Go to policies, administrative templates, Edge update, and we're gonna go to Edge dev. And you can see here are our version management policies and update policies. And I haven't configured any yet. But what I wanna do is roll back to the last version of Edge dev. So to do this, I'm gonna set two policies. The first one I'm going to set is rollback to target version. And so this policy will actually allow you to go to previous versions of Edge. By default, like I said before, we only allow upgrades. So to enable this, I'll just set this. And now when I go to this other policy called target version override, if I set this to a version that's less than the version that's installed, this rollback to target version will allow me to do that. And when I do, whichever version I set here, Edge will update itself either forwards or backwards to this version. So I'm going to set this as enabled. And the last version of Edge that I was using was 86.0.608.2. So I'll just set that here. Okay, and we will refresh this. and you can see that they are set. And so now we'll just apply it to our domain. Yes, okay. So now let's go back to our client, and you can see that it's still on that newer version, 86.615.3. And so let's go ahead and make sure that it's received the latest policy updates. So we'll do a GP update. And as soon as Edge Update gets this policy, this new target version policy, and it runs its update check, it's automatically going to set Edge to whichever version you've specified. And so what I'm doing here is I'm actually doing like kind of a manual check for updates just to speed this up along. So we'll just refresh this page and there's an update. So what Edge is doing right now is it's actually rolling back to that version that I had specified in the group policy. And so normally this will happen behind the scenes, transparently to users. That's all you have to do is set this target version policy, enable rollback, and if your devices are cloud connected, this is a super convenient way to treat issues that you might encounter. So now that you've seen how to do rollback, I'll just leave you with a couple things. The first is that Edge 86 is the first version that you can roll back to. So if you want to try this in a production environment, you'll want to wait till Edge 87 is out so that you can roll back to 86. The other thing is that we have a guide that walks you through all the steps of how to do rollback, how to enable sync, what data is stored in snapshots, and that sort of thing. And that's available at aka.ms/edge rollback. Thank you so much for watching.